Hi everyone, I'm Giuseppe and this is the second video about our project, Sense. In order to understand why we chose to implement Sense on an FPGA, it's important to define what are the expected features of our project. In particular, we expect the prosthesis to be responsive, which means that the delay between the patient's intention to perform a certain task and the actual execution of the movement should be minimized. Also, it should be lightweight, because the patient has to wear it all day long without any distress. And finally, it should be repairable and upgradable, so it does not become obsolete after just a few years. From all these considerations, we defined the three main factors on which we based our comparison between the different architectures, that are the computational power, the power consumption, which is related to the size of the battery, and finally the reconfigurability. For our comparison, we didn't consider CPUs or GPUs as possible solutions. In fact, because of their high energy requirements, they are not suited for embedded devices like Sense. Instead, we chose to compare three different architectures, all characterized by an high energy efficiency, that are ASIC, microcontroller, and FPGA. An ASIC is an integrated circuit designed for a specific application. For this reason, it offers great performance. However, it lacks reconfigurability, which means that every update requires the entire circuit to be redesigned and rebuilt from scratch. Also, the time and the cost associated with the production of an ASIC are very high. On the other hand, a microcontroller is very easy to reconfigure, but the performance it offers are not compatible with the real-time analysis of the data that we need. Finally, an FPGA can be reconfigured for a specific application, and for this reason, given the right algorithm, it may achieve a very high performance. However, the time required in order to find the best optimization for that algorithm may be also very high. After all these considerations, we chose to implement our project on an FPGA. In fact, even though programming an FPGA and finding the best optimizations for the algorithm are not easy tasks, it offers the perfect mix of energy efficiency and reconfigurability that we need. That's all for this video. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Slasher, and if you have any questions, feel free to contact us.